Welcome to EduNova's practical session of surface tension. In this session, we will determine the surface tension of water by capillary rise method using traveling microscope. Before going to the experiment, let us see what is surface tension and capillarity.
Surface tension. It is the tangential force exerted by the surface of the liquid per unit length. Take a beaker containing water. When you dip a capillary tube in the water vertically, the water level rises in the capillary tube above the water level in the beaker and remains constant due to capillarity. Let h be the height of the capillary rise. The diameter of the capillary tube, and half of the diameter gives the radius r of the capillary tube. Knowing the values of h is equal to height of the capillary rise, r is equal to radius of the bore, d is equal to density of the water, g is equal to the acceleration due to gravity, then surface tension of the water d is given by half into h plus r by 3 into rdg, and its units are dyne per centimeter.
Hope you got a clear picture about surface tension and capillarity. Now, let us go through the aim and apparatus required to perform this experiment.
Aim: to determine the surface tension of water by capillary rise method using traveling microscope. Apparatus: capillary tube, traveling microscope, beaker containing water, cork, pointer, and retort stand. A traveling microscope is a compound microscope fitted vertically on a vertical scale. The base of the traveling microscope consists of a leveling screws, which helps in adjusting the base horizontally. It can move up and down and left and right, carrying a vernier scale along with it. Here, you can see the horizontal main scale and vernier scale. Similarly, you can see the vertical main scale and vernier scale. At any given position, the readings are taken by combining the main scale and vernier scale readings. Now, let us see the least count of the traveling microscope. Here, 50 divisions of vernier scale is equal to 49 divisions of the main scale. So, 1 vernier scale division is equal to 49 by 50 main scale divisions. Since the least count is defined as the difference between one main scale division and one vernier scale division, least count is equal to one main scale division minus one vernier scale division, that is equal to one main scale division minus 49 divided by 50 main scale divisions, that is equal to 1 divided by 50 main scale divisions. Least count is equal to 0.01 millimeters, that is 0.001 centimeters.
Now, let me take you through the step-by-step procedure to perform the experiment. First and foremost, we need to find the height of the capillary rise in the capillary tube. To do so, take a clean glass capillary tube and fix the tube vertically to the stand. Then, take a pointer and fix the pointer parallel to the capillary tube. Now, dip the capillary tube in the water in such a way that the tip of the pointer just touches the surface of the water. Here, The rise of water in the capillary tube is due to the surface tension of water. Now, we measure the height of water using the traveling microscope. Before using the traveling microscope, we need to find the least count of the microscope. Here, each main scale division is 0.5 millimeters and 49 main scale divisions are equal to 50 vernier scale divisions. Therefore, least count is equal to 1 MSD minus 1 VSD, which gives us 0.001 centimeters. Now, looking through the eyepiece, we focus the microscope to the lower meniscus of the water level in the capillary tube. Here, we need to take proper care that the horizontal crosswires in the microscope should touch the lower meniscus of the water level. Here, you can clearly see that the horizontal crosswire touches the lower meniscus. Now, we need to note down the vertical scale reading of the microscope. Here, the main scale reading is 5.9 centimeters. Now, we look for the vernier coincidence. Here, the vernier coincidence is 14th division. Therefore, the total reading is 5.914 centimeters. Note this reading as H1. Now, remove the beaker without disturbing the positions of the capillary tube and the pointer. After that, looking through the eyepiece of the microscope, focus the microscope to the tip of the pointer in such a way that the horizontal crosswire should touch the tip of the pointer. Here, you can clearly see that the horizontal crosswire touches the tip of the pointer. Now, we note down the vertical scale reading of the microscope. Here, the main scale reading is 3.6 centimeters. Now, we look for the vernier coincidence. Here, the vernier coincidence is 30th division. Therefore, the total reading is 3.630 centimeters. Note this reading as H2. Now, the difference of H1 and H2 gives us the capillary rise. Note this reading as H. After finding the height of the capillary rise, we need to determine the radius of the bore of the capillary tube. To find the radius of the bore, we fix the capillary tube in horizontal position. Now, looking through the eyepiece, we focus the microscope to the bore of the capillary tube in such a way that the vertical cross wire touches one end of the bore of the capillary tube. Here you can clearly see that the vertical cross wire touches one end of the bore of the capillary tube. Now we note down the horizontal scale reading. Here the main scale reading is 1.75 cm. Now we look for the vernier coincidence. Here the vernier coincidence is 25th division. Therefore, the total reading is 1.775 cm. Note this reading as D1. Now, looking through the eyepiece, we move the microscope until the vertical cross wire touches the other end of the bore. Here, you can clearly see that the vertical cross wire touches the other end of the bore. Now we note down the reading of the horizontal scale. Here the main scale reading is 1.6 cm. Now we look for the vernier coincidence. Here the vernier coincidence is 49th division. Therefore, the total reading is 1.649 cm. Note this reading as D2. Now, the difference of D1 and D2 gives us the diameter of the bore. Off of this, we get radius of the bore. Note this as R. Knowing the height of capillary rise H and the radius of the bore R, we calculate the surface tension of the water. Now, we repeat the same procedure for two more times and we calculate the surface tension in each case. Then, we take the mean value as the surface tension of water.
The traveling microscope reading, when the cross mark is focused on the lower meniscus of the water, is 5.914 cm. Traveling microscope reading when the cross mark is focused on the tip of the needle is 3.63 cm. The difference between these two values gives us the capillary rise H, which is equal to 2.280 cm. Similarly, the values for the second readings are mean H is equal to H1 plus H2 by 2, that is 2.280 plus 2.259 by 2. Therefore, mean H is equal to 2.269 cm. The traveling microscope reading when the cross mark is focused on the right end of the bore is 1.775 cm. The traveling microscope reading when the cross mark is focused on the left end of the bore is 1.649 cm. The difference between these two values gives us the diameter of the bore, that is 0.126 cm, and half of it gives us the radius R, which is equal to 0.063 cm. Similarly, the values for the second readings are mean R is equal to R1 plus R2 by 2, that is 0.063 plus 0.065 by 2. Therefore, mean R is equal to 0.064 cm. Least count of the vernier scale of the microscope LC is equal to 0.001 cm. height of the water level in the tube H is equal to 2.269 centimeters. Radius of the bore R is equal to 0.064 centimeters. Acceleration due to gravity G is equal to 980 centimeter per second square. Density of the water D is equal to 1 gram per centimeter cube. Therefore, the surface tension of the water T is equal to 1 by 2 into H plus R by 3 RdG dyne per centimeter. That is equal to 1 by 2 into 2.269 plus 0.064 by 3 into 0.065 into 980 into 1 dyne per centimeter, which is 71.15 dynes per centimeter. Precautions: a capillary tube should have uniform bore. The water taken in the beaker should be clean, and any impurity may lower the surface tension. The water column rise should be free from air bubbles. Readings should be taken without any parallax error. The tube should be clamped vertically. Internal diameter of the capillary tube should be measured in two mutually perpendicular directions.
Now you are able to determine the surface tension of any liquid by capillary rise method using traveling microscope. Thank you for watching this video.